Well, this morning's topic is called being the meat in the sandwich. This is a topic about how a person on the autism spectrum can be manipulated and actually used by people within a sort of a pawn sense, and I mean being, you know, like the pawn in the chess set. But what I'm wanting to say firstly is I had a great weekend in Stanthorpe, went to Girraween National Park, had a chance to relax, get out of Brisbane, it was really good. But now, when I was thinking, coming back when I was driving, I was thinking about some of the experiences I've had being an autistic person, of being the meat in the sandwich. Some years ago, about 12 years ago, when I lived in Armidale, New South Wales, I was really lonely and wanting to have friendship and that sort of thing and get support. So I joined an organisation which has been around for quite some hundreds of years. I don't want to name what that organisation is. And at the time, I was finding that I was sort of more or less the meat in the sandwich between two factions of people. And the thing which was happening was that I was sort of more or less being used to get back at another person, and then that other person was using me to get back at these other people. And I thought to myself, you know, I knew that this was happening to me at the time, but because I was very young at the time, I thought, well, you know, this is pretty unusual, or, you know, this is a political situation, and within human society there's always politics in any organisation, no matter where you work. There's people that are in hierarchical positions that may have an ego and think that they're better than everybody else, and that everybody has to look at their magnificence and think how wonderful they are, and in fact sometimes they can be people that just don't really seem to have it together somehow. But anyway, when I was in this organisation, these people were wanting to get back at this other person, and they more or less kept saying to me, well, or showing their dislike of this other person by saying this person, because this person was Dutch, that he was arrogant and so forth. And at one particular time, I mean, this person that was Dutch didn't really have very good diplomacy skills, and I used to go into his shop in Armidale, and I used to talk to him, you know, just because he was used to say things up front. He was very straight talking in terms of he'd say things as they are without any sugar-coated crap to them. But anyway, one time he was particularly rude to me, and I thought, well, you know, I'm not going to let this get away. And I thought, well, because I'd been told so much by this group of people that he was arrogant and so forth, I went into his shop and I said, look, you're just arrogant and rude, and, you know, I find that very offensive or whatever. And when I said that, you know, more or less this man was he's passed away since now, but he was very sort of reactive towards it, and I can understand it. But when I knew this behaviour was happening, I tried to contact a person in a higher position about it and to say, look, this is what's happening to me, and I don't like it. I don't like the way I'm being used like this, you know, being the meat in the sandwich. But the problem was that they did nothing about it, and there wasn't any disciplinary measures or whatever that were able to be enforced to prevent this sort of behaviour from continuing. But I still find today that I still feel like I can be used as meat in the sandwich within factions, because there's always this group of people that may not like the other person or what have you, and sometimes you get caught up in it and you get sick of it because you really feel like you're being tossed around and more or less used, because not for who you are but what people, how you can be sort of controlled and to get back at other people and this sort of a thing. And I just think, well, you know, because people on the autism spectrum, because we're vulnerable, and thinking that because people are being friendly to us and when they're actually using us, we think that they care about us and have an interest in who we are as people and want to communicate with us, but actually we're being used like pawns in a chess set to actually get back at other people, or to be entwined between, involved in between two factions of people. And it really, I can remember when I, back to the school days, that there was a boy that was not very sort of liked, and I was more or less sort of given this friendship. This is in primary school, that if I was sort of nice to this boy, that I would be praised and this sort of a thing. And I used to think at the time, when I thought, well, I guess I'm just fitting in and they're accepting me. But I thought to myself later, I thought, well, why am I doing this? You know, why is this sort of behaviour happening? And is it, it certainly is wrong. But it still happens in the adult world, where persons on the autism spectrum can just be used because they what to get back at someone else, because, you know, we're very literal, and I guess we say what's on our mind, and we can be very naive towards people and sort of wanting acceptance. And sometimes I think autistic people can be used as meat in the sandwich, because we can't always ascertain whether people are genuinely caring about us or just using us to get back at someone else. And can be very difficult, and very, you know, it's not a very good thing to happen at all. And I find that it being the meat in the sandwich is certainly not a pleasant experience, and I still get it, or still vulnerable, I guess, to it to today, because you know, it's just you're just wanting acceptance from people, and sometimes you don't know whether what people's motives are, or how politics in a organisation may operate, and you function on your own intelligence to try and work out who is right and who is wrong. And it can be very difficult, and can also lead to implications if it's in a sort of a work environment or a organisation or so forth, because you may be unaware of exactly how you're being used, if you are, and what implications that may have on you and your survival within that organisation, etc. So it's a rather difficult topic to cover, but if anybody's interested and feel that they may also have been the meat in the sandwich in terms of factions or whatever, it'll be great to hear from you and hear your stories. Thanks very much for watching.